Back to another episode of Dirt Fishing America. I am Brandon Rainice. I am standing on a cliff in the middle of nowhere. It's really windy, but I wanted to shoot an episode all about getting to the middle of nowhere because as a treasure hunter like me, sometimes I have to get into the middle of nowhere because that's where treasures are. All the good stuff has already been found close to people, so you got to get away from people. And to do that, you need special tools. Now, I've been getting a lot of questions about my Jeep Gladiator, so I thought I would do a special episode just about the Jeep and some of the extra equipment that I bring along when I get off the grid. Real quick, before we get started, there's a lot of flies. Sorry if you see them land on my face. Also, I'm not gonna be making any money off of this video. All the products that I recommend to you guys are things that I have learned to use by trial and error, and this is where I am currently in my overlanding experience. Let's jump right in. It's a 2020 Jeep Gladiator. I chose to go with the Jeep Gladiator because it has most of the components that a regular Jeep has, like the four-door JKs or JLs, but just a little bit more extra room for all the crap I have to haul out in the middle of nowhere. For me, it made the most sense to go ahead and get the Rubicon because it has lockers both front and rear and push button sway bar disconnects. Those features are important to me in the area that I drive in. If they're not for you, then don't worry about the Rubicon, just get the Sport. Now, I knew immediately when I bought this that I wanted to get a lift kit for it just because of how long that wheelbase is. You can see there the breakover point, not the typical Jeep that I was used to. When I purchased this, I had the dealer put on the 2-inch Mopar factory lift with the Fox shocks. And I did that because I wanted to maintain warranty. Also, I wanted to be able to get a 35 to a 40-inch tire underneath here, so that way I can haul butt in the desert with big tires and not have to worry about stuffing them up into my wheel wells and losing parts of my Jeep along the trail. When it came to choosing a bumper for my front end, I actually had some prerequisites that I really wanted it to meet, and it needed to be kind of lightweight. It needed to be able to adapt to the LED Rubicon Jeep JL Jeep JT factory fog lights. Needed to accommodate up to a 12,000 pound winch, and also the bull bar up in front couldn't block the view of my forward facing trail cam. That meant that I end up with the Quadratec QRC bumper. Inside of that QRC bumper from Quadratec, I got the 12,000 pound Smitty built wireless winch. It's got 100 foot of synthetic line. I'm new to synthetic line, kind of a little bit of a learning curve there. So far I'm loving it, and it's a good weight savings, especially when you're looking at overlanding and every ounce matters. I mentioned before that I've got the LED factory fog lights installed in the bumper here. I also have the factory LED headlights in the actual Jeep, which I highly recommend because when it comes to headlights and Jeep, let's just say that the other ones are not so good. Definitely go LED if you can. Speaking of illumination, I've also been hooked up by KC Highlights with some aftermarket lighting components that really makes it a breeze to navigate trails at nighttime. First and foremost, my ditch lights mounted here on the A-pillars. These are the G34s, and these are in a wide beam pattern. These are off-road trail rated only. Do not use these on the road because they're really, really bright. I've also got the 6-piece LED Cyclone Ground Rock Kit, and this goes underneath the Jeep and helps illuminate everything underneath there. So that way I'm not getting bit by snakes when I jump out here in the desert, I'm not getting hung up on rocks at nighttime, etc. My spot man can always see under my belly, which is really important on a Jeep this long. Finally, on the back bumper, I custom mounted my C2 area floodlights into this little reflective component on the back of my Jeep. Friendly reminder, do not just buy any old light bar or LED light off of Amazon. Quality components matter, especially when you need them most. You need Cree LEDs, watertight housings, gaskets on the back, the whole nine. KC Highlights has you covered when it comes to that. Holy cow, it's windy. All of my electrical components are wired through the trigger accessory controller system, specifically the six shooter, which allows me to plug in six auxiliary plug and play items right in through here, all controlled through a slick little RF rocker controller or your phone, where you have more features like dimming and strobing and a whole bunch of other nonsense you'd probably never use on a trail, maybe a parade. If you have gear that you're transporting that absolutely has to arrive in one piece, unharmed, trust no other box than this one right here. Where'd it go? The Rome Adventure Co. boxes are great. They're bulletproof. They've got this little gasket here that's a liner. No dust, no water, nothing. Gas-assisted struts to open it. Three latches, lockable. It's even got a little thing over here for air pressure if you go up or down in elevation and you're struggling to get it open because it's so airtight with that gasket in there. You just pop that little valve. Or, worst case scenario, you run out of room in the old Yeti, throw some more ice in here, and now you got a drain plug complete with bottle opener. And actually, the gas strut thing, it's not just to assist you opening it, it's so it doesn't smash your fingers when you're trying to get your gear out when the wind is freaking. Thanks for hanging out and talking shop with me today. It was a lot of fun. I'm going to be incorporating a lot more of that into my channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you on the next go round.